go to the rim.
Josh Wallace off to Sullivan. 2 seconds. That'll do it, and Ole Miss survives another one. They go to 6-0 for the first time in the history of Rebel basketball.
You asked me at the outset, Dave, was this team a team that should be in the NCAA tournament?
Welcome back, everybody. Hope you guys are enjoying your weekend. Today, I'm going to be talking about Marshall Henderson. If you guys haven't checked my other videos out, please check them out. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. For those of you who don't know what polarizing means to divide opinions into two sharp camps. So either you love the person and you agree with the person, or you disagree with the person and you think the person is wrong. Without further ado, let's hop into the video. Marshall Henderson was born on September 19, 1990 in Fort Worth, Texas. He is one of four siblings. Henderson attended L.D. Bell High School in Hearst, Texas and played for his father, Willie Henderson, who was the head coach. He scored over 2,000 points for his career and averaged about 26 points, 5 assists, and 5 rebounds his senior year of high school. He would then commit to play at Utah. In his only season at Utah, he averaged 12 points per game and was named to the honorable mention All-Mountain West team. He would then transfer to Texas Tech after his freshman year, but after the coach got fired during the end of that year, he transferred again to South Plains College in Levelland, Texas. There, he was named National Player of the Year and First Team All-American. Afterwards, he would transfer to Ole Miss, his fourth and final college, and would really get to get a better understanding of who Marshall Henderson was. In his first year at Ole Miss, he started 33 games, averaged 20.1 points, which was an SEC high, and led them to the NCAA tournament. That year, he was named second team All-SEC and SEC Tournament MVP. In his senior year, he would again be named to the All-SEC second team, but Ole Miss was bounced in the SEC quarterfinals. I first heard about Marshall Henderson when I was around 12 or 13 years old. I actually heard about him from my brother. My brother came up to me one day, he's like, "Yo, there's this guy named Marshall Henderson that plays for Ole Miss, and he was, you know, haunting Auburn, and he was doing this towards another team, and he was a good shooter, and he was, like, talking mad heat in interviews," and I think that's the first time I ever heard of him, but I never really knew a whole lot about his basketball career. Like, I never really got to see him play live or in person, so when I was coming up for ideas, I was talking to him and I was like, you know, I was thinking about doing an interview, video on Marshall Henderson. And he said that would be a very interesting one. And while I was watching film and watching footage of him, you could obviously see how good of a shooter he is and how good of a scorer he is. Another thing I noticed is that he plays with a lot of intensity and brings a lot of energy to the game. And I think that can be kind of a spark, you know, he can kind of be that spark plug for any team that, you know, if they're down, and, you know, he can be that guy to, like, lift them up and kind of, like, get their energy going and kind of, like, motivate them and stuff like that. You know, it's great to have somebody like that on your team. You need somebody to kind of be that spark plug, and you need somebody to, you know, have the confidence to take the big shots, and that's really what he had. You know what I mean? You know, some people, I think, you know, take it the wrong way. Some people take it as him being kind of arrogant and cocky. And some people love it. Some people, like, love the energy he brought to the game. And I thought it was contagious. I thought it helped them become a successful team, you know, on and off the court. And so, I don't know. It's, you know, whatever really your opinion is, you know, whatever you want to call it. If you want to call it cockiness, if you want to call it, you know, a lot of energy, high intensity. But, you know, it really worked for them, and it really worked for their team. When you look back on his most iconic moments, obviously the Auburn game comes to mind, the Florida game comes to mind, and a lot of people, I think, took that the wrong way. You know, you see him flapping his jersey at the Auburn fans, and you see him doing the gator clap at the Florida fans, and, you know, I feel like he was just this guy that, you know, didn't really care what people thought about him. You know, he had confidence in who he is, and he liked who he was, and he really kind of just blocked out, you know, all the negativity and kind of just played ball and just, you know, kind of just, you know, did who he was and was who he was. You know, he never really felt like he ever, you know, caved into the negativity and listened to what everybody was saying about him. And but, you know, there were definitely people that, you know, supported him. You know, you can watch, you know, videos on Marshall Henderson. There's people that say, you know, he was a great guy on and off the court. You know, he brought energy in practice. He brought energy to the games. And that's what's most important. You need energy in practice. You need energy in the games, you know, because unless if you don't have that, it's just dead. It's just dead. And you're not going to be a great team if you don't have great energy. In any sport, really, not just basketball.
Is he the most polarizing figure in college basketball history? It's debatable, no doubt. I don't think he's unanimously the most polarizing player in college basketball, but I just thought of it for thought, you know, is he really the most polarizing figure ever to play college basketball?
That's the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoy a three-day weekend. I hope you guys enjoy the playoffs tomorrow, and I'll catch you guys soon. Appreciate it.
Some jokes. He has some jokes.
For real,
Nick. This is real life. Did you get that on camera?
Yeah. Well, when I'm dancing, I hear a nice little beat. I just kind of like to. Hey. Hey.
Sounds like this could be an intro song. I don't know this song, but it jams. Some gospel for sure. That Fresh Prince.